Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and we're going to talk about topology in 3D modeling and why it's so important. Many 3D artists, whether they are juniors or seniors, are having problems with their topologies in 3D modeling. I'm going to try and cover the whole logic behind model topology and how you can instantly picture a finished 3D model in your head without even starting it. First thing that you need to understand is that every edge, every surface has its own trajectory, its own path. So I like to picture it as a road for this example. So if you see here, I have my polygons following the road in the distance. The movement that's happening here seems pretty logical. Let's take another example, a curved road. As you can see, the polygons are following the curve. Not many things can go wrong with a mesh like this, but what if we have a little bit more complex situation like this? Let's quickly model our main roads here. I've modeled each road separately and I made sure that all my polygons are quads, not triangles, not n-gons, pure quads. And I also made sure that all my polygons have approximately equal size, so just that they are all consistent. Now let's connect these and see what we're gonna do with the land in the middle. Now before any modeling, try to picture each line, each edge, like it's radiating energy on a side you need to model. That should nicely describe the directions your polygons must go in and should help you out with your modeling process. Let's first connect all the roads together. And then we're going to create our first polygons based on our radiating energy movement. And from that point, we're going to be building our model inwards, where we will be trying to keep all polygons as quads as much as possible. And we will try to keep those radiating energy polygons kind of merging together nicely so that they form a really nice shape. After a short amount of time, I managed to get a result like this. I had to remodel original roads a little bit so that all of them, since they're all connected together, can function as one big object. As you can see, even in the middle, I tried to preserve the original size of our polygons that we defined in the beginning, and it turned out pretty okay. Now, a model like this can be subdivided with no problem. It can even be animated, deformed, and it will perform nicely. Of course, if at some situations you do need to use a triangle or an n-gon, it's not the end of the world. On the other hand, they do serve a purpose and people use them frequently, like myself, but you need to be careful with them. Now let me show you an example of a project that I did for a company called Blink, where I was given a task to model this ceiling fan. Now it had to be super highly detailed because we would need to produce a lot of close-up renders and my topology had to be spot on for this type of job. Now let me show you how the mesh looks like. If I zoom in here, for example, you see I have these large openings here and all of them have those support loops surrounding my main openings everywhere and they're literally keeping the whole shape to produce some really nice chamfers, and overall, the reflection on this object is gonna look really, really nice. On the other hand, if you take a look at here, you can actually see on this object that I had to punch the holes for the screws, and you can actually see the edges surrounding that shape where my hole is. On the other hand, those edges, those surrounding edges, are merging slowly with the rest of the shape for this fan holder. Now, if I add a turbo smooth to this, let me just select it. Okay, I need to ungroup first. But if I add my turbo smooth to this, you can see that everything performs nicely. Everything blends nicely. But most of all, in the render, when you look at it, like I said, no matter how big of a close-up you have, it will always look nice. On the top, I have these openings also. And when you look at them from a close-up, you're gonna see that all of these nicely done topologies, all of these nicely done holes, all of them have this really, really nice touchable feeling reflection. So in 3D, my theory is that the reflection is either your worst enemy or your best friend. If you have a bad topology, reflection is gonna be the first thing that will snitch on you and it will be merciless. So yeah, get your topologies right and your model will be thankful for it. Your render will be thankful for it, but mainly the person who is paying you for the job is gonna be really happy. That's it, guys. I hope you liked the video and learned a few bits about topology. I wish you good models, brutal topologies, and happy clients. Bye.